Alright guys, today we're going to be talking about Pokemon investments here in March of 2024. So guys, sit back, relax, and let's talk about it right after this. Alright guys, I'm Andy with Northwoods TCG, and today we're going to be taking a look at some Pokemon investments, five of them to be exact, here in March of 2024. But before we go any further, make sure you guys hit that subscribe, hit that notify, and last but not least, make sure you guys hit that like button so that you can help out the channel. Now, before we move forward, these are going to be different investments. They're going to be coming from different eras. They're going to go all the way back to the beginning of Sword and Shield, all the way up until recent sets here that were just released. So today we're going to be talking about the pros and cons of both, why I think they're good investments, why I think there could be some potential pitfalls for these particular investments, and why I think that they will work through them and not have much of a hindrance overall to your investment futuristically for the next few years. So first one we're going to jump into is going to be this one, which is going to be Darkness Ablaze. All right, guys, here we are, and everybody that's been a naysayer about Darkness Ablaze, well, I hate to tell you, it's following the trend of almost every other Pokemon investment that we've seen so far, and it is doing a nice little gain up. So as you can see right now, a booster box is going for $145. I told people to buy these right around $115 when they got reprinted, and currently we are just seeing an upward trend here for the last 3 months in this particular product. So if I scroll down, we can see the graph for Darkness Ablaze going for the last 3 months. You can see here we were at about $132, $133 here at the beginning of the month, $133.23 to be exact. And we've just seen a nice steady increase for the last 3 months, all the way up to around $151. So once again, we're seeing some really good gains on these particular boxes. Even these are $145, but they also got $13 shipping. You can pick these up a little bit cheaper on eBay. There are some opportunities still out there. And if you do Google search it for some reliable sources out there, you can also find them a little bit cheaper than this. TCG Player, once again, is not the end-all be-all when it comes on to purchasing Pokemon products, but they give us a very clean and good reference overall to the performance. Now, do I see any pitfalls to Darkness Ablaze currently? I do not. They're not going to get reprints. Overall, what's out there is out there. Comparatively to a lot of, in my opinion, comparatively to a lot of the other older products when it comes down to the release or newer releases of the Sword and Shield era, so those ones that are done after Evolving Skies, like Chilling Rain Forward, this one has a relatively lower print rate comparatively, in my opinion. It just isn't as much of it out there as you would expect. So once again, we're seeing some really good gains, some really good upper movement on Darkness Ablaze, and I think this is going to continue. I think this is where we are at when it comes down to it, and if we even go out to the last 6 months, you can see it had a little bit of drop at 155. We've seen a little bit of drop with everything else. The whole market kind of had that little bit of a slump, and once again, we're seeing it come right back up to that particular number again. So overall, yes, you could have waited and you could have maybe bought them at 129. But once again, if you are new to this market at 130 to 145, you think that's going to make a huge difference in the next 3 to 5 years? I do not. I think overall the performance is going to continue. It's a Charizard set, guys. Charizard sets always still seem to do very well. Even though the Charizard in it doesn't have much value overall, it still is a Charizard chase, and it's a chase that people like to have, and it's a reasonable chase currently at this price, even compared to like Brilliant Stars. So overall, I think that this one will do rather well. I think there's some really good opportunity futuristically on this one, and I think we're just going to continue to see steady growth on this as we're seeing for the last 3 months for continuing on from this point in time. I just don't see big slumps unless the whole market slumps again like we saw there on the graph. Moving on to the next one, which is going to be another Charizard set. All right, guys, here we are. We are Brilliant Stars. Now, Brilliant Stars is another one. It's still available on Pokemon Center. Once again, this is why I say don't use TCG Player as the end-all be-all. Right now, they're looking at $165 with shipping on this particular booster box. Right now on TCG Player, they are cheaper out there at Pokemon Center. So if you're looking at Brilliant Stars and you live in the United States or Canada, use Pokemon Center. You can buy them for $144.90 or $143.99, and you don't have to pay shipping on it. So you get free shipping on it. So you're actually able to save quite a bit of money at that point. Overall, I definitely do like Brilliant Stars. I think Brilliant Stars is a very strong set. It has that nice alternate art Charizard V inside of it, along with that Arceus V inside of it. It has a lot to offer with that gold Arceus and also a lot of nice full arts and stuff inside of here too for each one of those characters. So overall, I think it's a well-rounded booster box in general, a well-rounded set. It has the trainer gallery, the beginning of the trainer gallery. Once again, a really nice layout when it comes down to trainer gallery cards. This is probably my second favorite trainer gallery when it comes down to the four that we have at the end of Sword and Shield, of course. Lost Origins is my favorite Trainer Gallery set that came out in a booster box set. This one's my second. So overall, I think that these both have very good upfront value to them, and they're going to continue to gain because of the strength of that Trainer Gallery on top of the chases that are in these particular sets. It just gives you kind of that double banger on these sets to really push this value up, and we've seen it time and time again. If we go down here into the graphs, last 3 months we've seen a little bit of a decrease in it, but once again, it's available on Pokemon Center. So for it to maintain this price of around $161, it's going to be very difficult comparatively to wanting to keep wanting to drive down closer to that $145 range. And that's just going to be a persistent problem that it has until it's sold out on Pokemon Center. But guys, this is probably the next one to sell out on Pokemon Center. And I don't see any reprints currently on this particular booster box coming. There's no reason for Pokemon to go back into reprinting this. This will actually be a completely dead set in another year when it comes down to rotation. Overall, they're really pushing the Scarlet and Violet era and the movements in the Scarlet and Violet era rather than focusing on Sword and Shield at this point in time, which means to me these prices are going to maybe bounce around here for a little bit. But once this sells out on Pokemon Center, I feel that this is going to be the next set to really jump up, just like we've seen with Chilling Rain, just like we've seen with Fusion Strike here, as it recently sold out on Pokemon TCG or PokemonCenter.com. So as these sell out on Pokemon Center, we're continuing to see up to a $20 gain almost within a week or two of doing so. So overall, really good opportunity here still in Brilliant Stars to pick that up at Pokemon Center for $145 with $146 with tax, depending on where you live, and with free shipping to get that little bit of a gain too. I mean, you're already looking at some value inside of that box, even if you sold it on TCG Player. Not a lot. You got about a $4 gain on those boxes just by flipping them real quick. But that does give you an opportunity there also. Just to be a consideration that you're already building some value inside of those just by buying them from Pokemon Center. Moving on to the next one, which is going to be this. All right, we're going to be on the booster box trend here today, guys. The first three of them are going to be booster boxes, and these are... This one, of course, is Lost Origins booster box. This is also running about right around that $160 range when you talk about the shipping. So you got $15 shipping, you got $145 for the booster box. Yep, you're at $160. Overall, not surprising. This set is really, really hot. The Tina chase is extremely popular. And then, of course, you got that really nice Trainer Gallery when it comes down to the Pikachus inside of that particular box. Overall, this set is a really, really strong set. It's probably my second favorite set. Brilliant Stars is my favorite set of the Trainer Gallery sets, but the Trainer Gallery is better in Lost Origins, and Brilliant Stars has the second best Trainer Gallery. So they kind of flip-flop for Trainer Gallery and set. And that's exactly why I think we see these two kind of bouncing up and down next to each other. This one's a little bit newer, just came out of a reprint. But even after the reprint here, guys, we're still seeing some really good gains on this. I think, once again, we are stuck at around that $145 as a list price, and that's what their trick is. They're selling it for $145 on here because Pokemon Center still has this available. So even if you go to Pokemon Center, you can save yourself the shipping on each one of these boxes. You can take advantage of that currently. You can also skim the markets in other places. I've been able to see some Lost Origins boxes as low as $135 to under $140 pretty readily on different sites, whether you're looking for some different Pokemon sites that are selling them or even TikTok. I've even seen them on Instagram shops now that they're running those, Facebook. All of which have some little bit better deals than we see on TCG Player and eBay, and even beating Pokemon Center currently. After a large reprint, there are still some TCGs sitting on some of this product that they are trying to move at a little bit more reasonable value. So overall, Lost Origins, a really good box set. I do like the set itself. I like Brilliant Stars set a little bit better, but I like the Trainer Gallery a lot better in Lost Origins. And I think that in the future, Lost Origins could actually maybe potentially outperform the Brilliant Stars just because of that stronger Pikachu Trainer Gallery inside of it, and the Gengar set inside of there. Gengar card also is a really popular one when it comes down to the actual set in the Trainer Gallery. So there's some really good value, some really good opportunity overall. I think the Lost Origins box, yes, some people would say you already missed a train. I do agree, but once again, these videos are always based on the fact that you're just coming in today. I see so many new people coming in and telling me, hey, I'm new to the market. What do you think of this investment? Or I'm new. I've only been doing this for a few months. What do you think about doing this? And this is what these videos are based on, guys. This is at this moment in the market, not what you could have done a year ago. Yes, a lot of these products you could have bought better a year ago, but if you're here today, there's still got some great opportunities, and I see some really good growth in these futuristically, and I feel really safe suggesting these ones as good investments here in the near future. Moving on to the next one, which is going to be this. All right, here we are. We're at the mini tins. I picked this one specifically because it's going for $20, which I don't know why the Slowpoke is the most expensive one. Maybe there's better poles in it. Maybe somebody figured out a secret to it. But overall, there's some really good value in these current tins. And you can see right here, we've got these, the slowpoke tin right now for $20. But they do range anywhere from, let me look at my notes, between $12 and $20. So there are some $12 ones. There are some $20 tins. Overall, they are doing really well. The tins themselves are really gaining some value. They're all running about $17, $18. So from the MSRP, if you would have bought them at the $11.98, which you could get, they're still out there, guys. I've been finding them at some Walmarts. I've been finding them at GameStop every once in a while. I've also been getting them at my local LCS. So we've been having some opportunities to pick these up. Double-edged sword of this, it is Pokemon 151. And I'm going to put up that disclaimer that this set is fairly new. It's only not, 6 months old? And with that being said, there could be a great opportunity for this thing to get a reprint, another reprint. We just got some booster bundles and ETB reprint, and we did see those go through the market, and we've seen some opportunities in those. But once again, the mini tins are not out of the woods. The set itself is not out of the woods overall for reprints. So I would be considering that before really dumping a ton of money into Pokemon 151. But if you can get on these tins and you can find them at MSRP out there in the wild, there's definitely some great value on them right away. You get that good burst right off the bat of just having some value inside of them. Yes, you may see it drop a little bit if they get a reprint of these mini tins. They don't usually reprint very many times the mini tins, but if they do, I still think Pokemon 151 has got enough popularity, enough surging, and enough like of it to actually see some really good value futuristically in it. So overall, 151 mini tins definitely looking like a good buy currently. Reprint warning is on this one, so I will put that out there for you guys so you know that there is a potential for a reprint just because of the age of this set. And that's going to lead us to the next one, which is going to be the final one, which is this. All right, as you can see on the screen, 151 booster bundles. Now, I put this up there because there are some opportunities to buy these a little cheaper. At one point, they were surging up quite a bit, and now they've gotten a reprint of these. I was able to pick up quite a few of them for myself, which was really great to be able to see these out on the wild again. Best Buy, Target, Walmart, all these places were selling them, and they were all selling them at MSRP. So you were able to pick them up around that $26.98 for this particular bundle. And as you can see here, yeah, we're at $24.75, but once again, that $24.75 right here is kind of a joke underneath my name because they put a $15 price tag for the shipping, which means you're sitting at about $40. And that seems to be the consistent price on them right now on TCG Player. If we scroll down here, we're down to about $38, $39 roughly on these particular as the market value on these. As you can see, we were up to almost $41 at one point in time, and then we've just seen a little slump. And if you could have bought them here at one point, even on TCG Player, to around $37. But that's all because of the reprint, guys. The reprint was really the reasoning behind that particular dive in the price. And once again, I think that's what happened here too. This was the announcement of the reprint. So we saw a real big sell-off of these because people didn't know what the results were going to be of these particular reprints. But now we've kind of gotten the results of them, and they were eating up really fast. Every place is sold out. You can't get these any longer from any of the normal sources, any of the standard purchasing places like Target, Walmart, or Target, Walmart, Best Buy, or even GameStop. They're all sold out of them currently, so there's no opportunity to pick these up again online that I can find for under that $35 range. So once again, we're pushed this up a little bit past the $35 range. As you can see next to me on the bottom right below my head there, you can see the current sales on them is sitting about $40. So this price is going to go back up again today. We're going to be getting closer and closer to that $41 range again on TCG Player just because it was a reprint. There was quite a bit of it, not going to lie, but it actually got chewed up extremely fast. People really do like these booster bundles. And overall, that's why I've been kind of thinking that these holiday set booster bundles are definitely going to be good values futuristically when it comes down to purchasing in the Pokemon TCG. And I think these things are probably here to stay. And I think they're going to have a really good place overall and be a strong contender for a great investment futuristically. So there we go, guys. I'm going to switch over to the other screen. All right, and we're back. So today, this is what we're going to be talking about. Five Pokemon products that you can be considering here for investment in March. Take your chances now. Do your digging. The Pokemon 151 booster bundles, definitely another one, though. Remember, there could be a reprint of 151. Are they going to maybe do the booster bundles? A really, really good chance. If they do another reprint of Pokemon 151, there's definitely a really good chance that they're going to come in the form of those booster bundles and ETBs. That's just what they typically do when it comes down to these sets in these holiday sets, because these are the two main driving factors of these sets. They don't have the booster boxes like we do in a normal mainstream set. So overall, there is a good chance for a reprint on these ones. So once again, we might see this value, but it's a good news that we actually saw how 151 performed when the reprint came, that it actually saw that drop down the MSRP and then quickly recovered. And the prices went right back up to $35. So if you can pick them up at MSRP still, there's some places out there. I have not seen them, But if you could potentially find them out there, then there's definitely some good chances to take advantage of that and get them at that MSRP, and you're going to have some really good value built into these right away. I also think that they're going to continue to move up rather well. As the time goes on, these 151 booster bundles are showing that they want to be a higher price. And as there's no reprints coming in the near future, and as the reprints kind of disappear on these, I think that they will be a very good value overall compared to even an ETB when you're talking about the number of packs you get for the price you pay for them now. Overall, guys, hopefully this is a good video. Hopefully some good information and helps you get a little bit of a knowledge for where you want to go here in the Pokemon market in 2024, in March of 2024. And hopefully this helps you out in your investment journey in the Pokemon TCG. Hopefully you get some good knowledge, and hopefully I earned your subscribe today. That'd be greatly appreciated. Hit the subscribe. One more time, a reminder for that. Also, make sure you hit the like on this video. Helps me out a ton to hit that like video and keep this channel or in this video moving forward. Other than that, check out the two videos at the end. I will put them up for you for your information afterwards. And we'll see you next time here on Northwoods TCG.